हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज असरा सुल्ताना, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन ट्रिपली डिपार्टमेंट, वर्किंग इन ISL इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज. सो इन टुडेज क्लास आई एम गोइंग टू टेल अबाउट पावर एंगल इक्वेशन एंड पावर एंगल कर्व ऑफ सिंक्रोनस मशीन्स. सो बिफोर सीइंग द पावर एंगल कर्व, वी विल सी द टॉपिक्स विच वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन द प्रीवियस क्लासेस. सो आई हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द व्हाट इज स्टेबिलिटी एंड व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ स्टेबिलिटी. So what is the power system stability? The power system stability is the ability of the system to come back to its normal stable operation when it is being subjected to certain disturbances. Okay, so according to what type of disturbance it is created on the system, we have divided the stabilities into three types. They are steady state stability, transient stability and dynamic stability. Okay. So steady state stability is the ability of the system to bring itself back to the stable or configuration following a small disturbance in the network. So it can be considered only during a very gradual and infinitely small power change. And the study of steady state stability is concerned with the determination of upper limit of machine loading before losing synchronism, provided the loading is increased gradually. Transient stability. Transient stability of a power system refers to the ability of the system to reach a stable condition following a large disturbance in the network condition. In all cases related to large changes in the system, like sudden application or removal of load, switching operations, line faults or loss due to excitation, the transient stability of the system comes into play. So it is in fact dealing with the ability of the system to retain synchronism following a disturbance sustaining for a reasonably long period. Okay, transient stability short period, steady state stability short period, transient stability long period, dynamic stability small continuous disturbances. Okay, that is, dynamic stability of a system denotes the artificial stability given to an inherently unstable system by automatically controlled means. It is concerned to small disturbances lasting for about 10 to 30 seconds. So what is the dynamic stability? It is the study of power system which are subjected to small continuous disturbances. Then we have seen about the dynamics of synchronous machine, that is, kinetic energy is given by half g omega square, j is rotor moment of inertia, and omega sm is synchronous speed. Omega s can be written as p by 2 omega sm. So substituting omega sm as 2 by p omega s, so we can rewrite the kinetic energy equation as half j 2 by p square omega s into 10 power minus 6 into omega s. That is, this entire part we are taking as m, moment of inertia. So that is, j m is equal to j into 2 by p whole square omega s into 10 power minus 6. So we have defined inertia constant has such that gh is equal to kinetic energy, but kinetic energy is half m omega s. So from this equation I can write m is equal to 2gh by omega s, where g is machine rating in MVA and h is inertia constant in mj per MVA. So m is equal to gh by pi f, that is mj electric per electrical radius. If we have to find out in electrical degrees, then gh by 180 f. M is also called the inertia constant. Taking G as base, inertia constant in per unit we can write as M per unit is H by pi F, S square per electrical radians, or H by 180 F, H square per electrical degrees. Degrees means take pi as 180, okay? So inertia constant H as a characteristic value or a range of values for each class of machines. So we have seen this table also. So for turbo generator, if it is condensing, inertia constant 926 for 1800 rpm, for 3000 rpm 724. For non condensing, having a speed 3000 rpm, the inertia constant H is 423. Water wheel generator, slow speed inertia constant is 223, and for high speed inertia constant is 224. Synchronous condenser, large 1.25, small 1 is the inertia constant. Then synchronous motor with load varying from 1 to 5 and higher for heavy flywheels, then it is, the inertia constant is 2. So what we are observed from table, that the value of H is very higher for steam turbo generator than for water wheel generator. 30 to 60% of the total inertia of a steam turbogenerator unit is that of the prime mover, whereas only 4 to 15% of the inertia of a hydroelectric generating unit is that of water wheel, including water. Then we have seen very important concept, that is swing equation we have seen. So this diagram is showing the flow of mechanical and electrical powers in a synchronous machine. This is a generator. Generator is taking the mechanical energy and giving the electrical energy. PM is the representing mechanical power. P is electrical power. So motor is taking electrical energy. It is represented by PE. Giving the mechanical energy, that is power, is represented by PM. These are the torque and speeds, angular speeds. Okay. So this figure is showing the torque, speed and flow of mechanical and electrical powers in a synchronous machine. It is assumed that windage and friction and iron loss torque is negligible. So we are assuming here that the torque due to the friction, windage losses and iron losses are negligible. So differential equation governing rotor dynamics of a synchronous machine, we can write it as Jd square theta m by dt square equal to Tm minus Te. What is theta m here? Angle in radians. Tm is the turbine torque in Newton meter. Te is the electromagnetic torque developed in Newton meter. So rotor undergoes dynamics of synchronous machines and rotor speed changes by insignificant magnitude for the time period of interest. So this equation, that is d square theta m by dt square is equal to Tm minus Te, can be converted into its more convenient power form by assuming the rotor speed to remain constant at the synchronous speed omega Sm. So multiply this equation, this 12.3 equation, that is J delta d square theta m by dt square is equal to Tm minus Te. Multiply this by omega Sm on both sides. So we are going to get J omega Sm d square theta m by dt square into 10 power minus 6 is equal to Pm minus Pe, where Pm is mechanical power input in megawatts and Pe is the electrical power input in megawatts. Here stator copper loss is assumed negligible. So rewriting the equation, we are substituting the value of omega Sm as here. So omega S is equal to P by 2 omega Sm. Then we have taken the kinetic energy as half J, okay, that, like that. So what you can, J into 2 by P square omega S into 10 power minus 6. D square theta E by dt square is equal to Pm minus Pe megawatts, where theta E is angle in electrical and Pm minus Pe is equal to M d square theta E by dt square. Okay, we are going to get the equation as M d square theta E by dt square is equal to Pm minus Pe. So it is more convenient to measure the angular position of the rotor with respect to a synchronously rotating frame of reference. Let delta is equal to theta E minus omega S t, that is rotor angular displacement from synchronously rotating reference frame, called torque angle or power angle. Okay, this delta is called as torque angle or power angle. So we are writing d square theta e by dt square as d square delta by dt square. Okay, wherever theta is, d square theta e by dt square is there, replace that equation by d square, replace that term in the equation by d square delta by dt square. So in this equation, in place of d square theta e by dt square, I am writing d square delta by dt square. Okay, so now I am going to get the equation of m d square delta by dt square is equal to Pm minus Pe in megawatts. So m is defined already, we have seen that m is equal to gh by pi f. So substitute the value of m as gh by pi f. So into d square delta by dt square is equal to Pm minus Pe in megawatts. So dividing throughout by g, MVA rating of the machine we got, that is m per unit into d square delta by dt square is Pm minus Pe in per unit of machine rating as base, where m per unit is h by pi f. So h by pi f d square delta by dt square is equal to Pm minus Pe per unit. So this equation is called as swing equation. Okay. The equation 12, this is called as swing equation. It describes the rotor dynamics for a synchronous machine. It is a second order differential equation where the damping term proportional to g delta by dt is absent because of the assumption of a lossless machine and the fact that the torque of damper winding has been ignored. So this assumption is leading to pessimistic results in transient stability analysis. So damping is helping to stabilize the system. Okay, damping must be considered in dynamic stability studies. Since electrical power PE depends upon the sine of angle delta, swing equation is a non-linear second order differential equation. Now we are going to see for a multi-machine system, a common base must be chosen, that is G mag is equal to machine rating and G system is equal to system base. So we are going to write the swing equation, that is H by pi f d square delta by dt square is equal to Pm minus Pe, as G mag by G system, H mag by f d square delta by dt square is equal to Pm minus Pe G mag by system, or H system by pi f d square delta by dt square is equal to Pm minus Pe per unit in system base. So we are going to get H system is equal to H mag into G mag by G system, that is machine inertia constant in system base. So we are choosing a two machines on a common base and writing the swing equation for these two machines. For machine 1, we can write the swing equation as H1 by pi f d square delta 1 by dt square is equal to Pm1 minus Pe1 per unit, and H2 by pi f d square delta 2 by dt square Pm2 minus Pe2 per unit. Since the machine is rotating and swinging together, they are in unison, so we can write the delta 1 is equal to delta 2 is equal to delta. So adding these two equations, we can write H equivalent by pi f d square delta by dt square is Pm minus Pe, where Pm is equal to Pm1 plus Pm2, Pe is equal to Pe1 plus Pe2, Heq is equal to H1 plus H2. So the two machines swinging coherently are reduced to a single machine, and we can write the equation as H equivalent is equal to H1 mag G1 mag by G system plus H2 mag G2 mag by G system. So for any number of machine, we can extend the result, above result, which are swinging coherently. So let us come to the topic of power angle equation. In solving the swing equation, certain simplifying assumptions are made. Okay, there are three assumptions made. First one is mechanical power input to the machine will remain constant during the period of electromechanical transient of interest, that is, the effect of the turbine governing loop will be ignored, being much slower than the speed of the transient. Okay, so what we are assuming here, that the mechanical power input to the machine will remain constant during the period of electromechanical transient of interest. Effect of turbine governing loop will be ignored, being much slower than the speed of the, because it is much slower than the speed of the transient. So this assumption will lead to pessimistic result. Governing loop will help to stabilize the system. So second one assumption is that rotor speed changes are insignificant, which we have already seen while formulating the swing equation. Third one is the effect of voltage regulating loop during the transient is ignored. As a consequence, the generated machine EMF will remain constant. So this assumption will also lead to the pessimistic result, that is, voltage regulator helps to stabilize the system. Now let us see the simplified machine model. For a non-salient power machine, the per phase induced EMF terminal voltage equation under steady state condition is E is equal to V plus J XD ID plus J XQ IQ for XD greater than XQ, where I is equal to ID plus IG. Now, under transient conditions, XD is represented by XD dash, and that is greater than XD. XQ dash is equal to XQ, since the main field is on the D axis, and XD dash is less than XQ. So, difference is less than in this compared to this equation. That is E is equal to V plus J XD ID plus J XQ IQ. So during the transient, this equation, that is E is equal to V plus J XD ID plus J XQ IQ, will modify to E dash is equal to V plus J XD dash ID plus J XQ IQ. So here in this phasor diagram we can see, so E dash is equal to now V plus J XD dash ID plus J XQ IQ, and is equal to V plus jxq I minus id plus jxd dash id and is equal to e dash is equal to V plus jxq I e plus jxd dash minus xq id. Okay. So phasor diagram corresponding to these equations is this one, where V is the reference phasor, I is lagging V, and this is ID and IQ. Then we can see here IXQ dash IXQ IQ. And this is J XD dash minus XQ IQ. This is J XD dash ID. So this is the phasor diagram of a cylindrical machine. Since under present conditions, XD dash is less than XD, but XQ remains almost unaffected. So we are assuming here that XD dash is nearly equal to XQ. So now our equation becomes E dash is equal to V plus jxqi, and that is equal to V plus jxd dash I. So machine model corresponding to above equation, we are drawing it as a like this, that is E dash is equal to mod E dash angle delta, and connected in series with xd dash. Current is flowing here and this is the voltage. Okay, so this will apply to the cylindrical rotor machine also, that is where xd dash is equal to xq dash is equal to xs dash, that is transient synchronous reactance. Now let us see power angle curve. For the purpose of stability studies, the mod e dash, that is transient emf of generator motor, remains constant, or it is independent variable determined by the voltage regulating loop, but V, the generator determined terminal voltage, is a dependent variable. So what we are telling here, that mod E dash is an independent variable and V is a dependent variable. Therefore, the nodes or the buses of the stability study network pertaining to the EMF terminal in the machine model, which is shown here, while the machine reactors XD dash is absorbed in the system network as different from a load flow studies. The loads other than synchronous motors will be replaced by equivalent static admittances. That is, what is this equivalent static admittances? They are the admittances connected in shunt between transmission network buses and the reference bus. So this is so because load voltages vary during a stability study. In a load flow study, these remain constant within a narrow band. Now for a two bus system, if you see the figure, two bus stability study network, here we can see there are four ports. This is a two port, this is a two port network. Four terminals are there, 1, 2, R. Okay, so even to the first port E1 dash is connected, to the second port E2 dash is connected, and I1 is the current flowing in first port, I2 is the current flowing in second port. So we can write the Y bus matrix Y11, Y12, Y21, Y22. It is a 2x2 matrix. Okay, first term is Y11, second is Y12, third is Y21, fourth is Y22. Y12 will be equal to Y21. Complex power into bus will be given by Pi plus jQi is equal to Ei Ii conjugate. At bus 1, P1 plus jQ1 is equal to E1 dash Y11 E1 dash conjugate plus E1 Y12 E2 dash conjugate. But E1 dash is equal to mod E1 dash angle delta 1. And E2 dash is equal to mod E2 dash angle delta 2. And Y11 is given by G11 plus JB11. And Y12 is given as mod Y12 angle delta 12. Theta 12. So in the solution of swing equation, we have considered only the real power. Now, from this equation of P1 plus JQ1 is equal to E1 dash Y11 E1 dash conjugate plus E1 into Y12 E2 dash conjugate, we can write P1 as E1 dash square G11 plus E1 dash into E2 dash into Y12 plus cos delta 1 minus delta 2 minus theta 12. So similarly, we can write for us 2 also, E1 dash square into G11 is equal to PC, or E1 dash in mod E1 dash mod E2 dash into Y12 is equal to P max. Delta 1 minus delta 2 is delta, and phi 1 2 is pi by 2 minus gamma. Now this equation of P1 can be written as P1 is equal to Pc plus P max sine delta minus gamma, that is, this is called as power angle equation. Now for a purely reactive network, G11 is equal to 0, therefore Pc is equal to 0, it is a lossless network, theta 12 is pi by 2, gamma is, and therefore gamma is equal to 0. So Pe will be equal to P max sine delta, where P max is mod E1 dash mod E2 dash by x. So this is a simplified power angle equation, where x is equal to transfer reactance between nodes, that is between E1 dash and E2 dash. We have seen here the graphical plot of power angle equation, which we have stated earlier, that is, so what we are doing here now, the swing equation which we have got earlier, we are modifying, we are simplifying it as h d square delta by d by f dt square is equal to pm minus p max sine delta pu per unit, which is a non-linear second order differential equation with no damping. Okay, so this is the power angle curve for generator, that is on positive side, x-axis we are taking delta and y-axis pe power. So this is power angle curve. So y-axis power and x-axis angle. Okay. So this is positive value we are getting for generator. If it is in the negative value, then it is operating as a motor. Okay. These are the various values, that is P max, P E naught, Q naught, delta naught, P E naught plus delta P. Okay. And this is delta naught plus delta delta values. We are plotting it on the power angle curve. Thank you students for watching the video. This is a very very important topic. So in the exam you may be asked a question of what is power angle curve. For 2 marks also you can get or give the significance of power angle curve. You can get for 2 marks. Okay. So regarding swing equation, already I have said you. So you are going to get the question in 5 marks, or in the long questions you may get. Derive swing equation and write its significance in the operation of a power system network, and you may get a, you may expect a problem also for 2 marks. Already in the last class I have done one numerical. If you are given the values of frequency, number of poles, and what is the kV or MV of the machine, and inertia constant, if it is given, then we have to find out the kinetic energy of the rotor. Okay, or we can, or question can be asked to find out the frequency of oscillation, having synchronizing coefficient giving, and then giving the inertia constant and frequency will be given, system frequency. Then we have to find out the frequency of oscillation. Okay, so you may expect 2 problems based on these topics for 2 marks. Okay. So in the long questions also you may expect a question based on these numericals. So derived swing equation, or derived swing equation, you may get write short notes on deriving swing equation, or you may get a question of derived swing equation and write its significance, okay, in the operation of a power system network. Or you may be asked to draw the power angle curve for 2 marks, or to write the power angle equation for short or long questions. Okay students, I hope today's class is clear to everyone. Thanks for watching the video.